Shifting focus to the other scam now. After bureaucrats, it's now turn for the other society members to cry foul after Rahul Gandhi's intervention led to partial acceptance of the Inquiry Commission report. The managing committee of the society is short of a letter to the state government challenging the findings of Justice J.A. Patil Commission report. Here's the entire report.
The central government's Ministry of Environment and Forest has already ruled that Adarsh Cooperative Society was built without due permissions from Ministry of Environment, and unauthorized construction should be removed. It should be demolished.
The state cabinet's decision to partially accept the Adarsh Commission report has not gone down well with several quarters. After protests by some former bureaucrats indicted in the report, now members of the society too have shot off a letter to the state government. Headlines today is an exclusive possession of this letter. The letter has raised several questions on the report. It says that some of its findings were not even within its ambit. The report has many inaccuracies, is prejudiced, suppresses material facts, and is not in consonance with stipulated terms as given by the government. In fact, the commission has exceeded its brief beyond the scope of its inquiry without any regard to the procedures laid down under Section 8B of the Commission of Inquiry Act 1952. The letter also puts up a point-by-point rebuttal of the findings of the commission. It says the valuation of land was worked out by state government. It says selection of members was not arbitrary, but it was approved by the state government. It also refutes that no act was violated while reducing the width of the Prakash Pithe Road. The letter also says that the commission has exceeded its brief by claiming that the reduction of Prakash Pithe Road was not in public interest. Challenging the contention that the society did not seek environmental clearance, members say there was no requirement for the same.
ये वापस वापस जांच बिठाने का कोई मतलब नहीं है. जो गुनेगार है उनको आप उनको सबक सिखाओ, उनकी इंक्वायरी करो, लेकिन 103 मेंबर में सबने क्या बिगाड़ा है.
सम रिटायर्ड ब्यूरोक्रेट्स आर ऑलरेडी अप इन आर्म्स अगेंस्ट द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट ओवर द रिपोर्ट. वन ऑफ देम हैज इवन सेंट अ लीगल नोटिस टू द गवर्नमेंट. नाउ विद द सोसाइटी टू चैलेंजिंग द रिपोर्ट, द सिचुएशन इज सेट टू बिकम मोर कॉम्प्लिकेटेड.
While partially accepting the report, the state government has put the ball in CBI's court. As far as the environmental violations are concerned, the matter is already sub judice, and former bureaucrats indicted in the report also plan to take the legal route. It seems that the fate of this Adarsh building will be decided in a long-drawn legal battle. With camera person Kiran Sapkal, Kamlesh Sutar in Mumbai for Headlines Today.
My colleague Divesh Nair now joins me for more on the story. Divesh, Headlines Today is in possession of that exclusive letter that the members have written to the government, openly criticizing the government, a clear shift in their stance too. Why has this shift taken place?
Well, see, absolutely. You know, the situation at this point of time is the fact that the members have also gone against the government. Remember earlier when the report was not accepted by the cabinet, at that point of time, the members were singing a different tune altogether, praising the fact that, you know, the entire report was not up to the mark and it was a right decision taken by the cabinet, even right. Going ahead and praising Ashok Chauhan for the matter that he has no role to play in this entire other scam. Right. Now, what has happened is the fact that now with this acceptance of the report after Rahul Gandhi intervened and telling the Maharashtra CM that no corruption should be tolerated in the state, the report clearly indicts a lot of members saying that there were a lot of violation that was done by the other society while the construction. And right. Now the entire thing has been going against the members of the society, and for that, already former bureaucrats have been up in arms. And remember, few of the members who have flats in this Adarsh building are also former bureaucrats. So yes, everybody has been against the government at this point of time. So it would be a tricky situation for the government, and the entire Adarsh ghost will not be dying down, and there is a long legal battle ahead which is awaiting. Back to you.
Right, long legal battle awaiting clearly. Divesh Nair, thank you so much for joining us with that update. We'll keep coming back to you more.